गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी वर टॉकिंग अबाउट द सेकेंड चैप्टर दैट सॉरी थर्ड चैप्टर दैट इज द कोऑर्डिनेट ज्योमेट्री एंड वी स्टडीड इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी स्टडीड अबाउट द बेसिक ऑफ द कोऑर्डिनेट ज्योमेट्री स्टार्टेड विद द नंबर सिस्टम्स. द फर्स्ट टॉपिक वॉज द नंबर लाइन. राइट, वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट टू टाइप्स ऑफ नंबर लाइन्स हियर इन दिस चैप्टर. दैट इज वन इज द हॉरिजॉन्टल नंबर लाइन एंड द सेकेंड वन इज द वर्टिकल नंबर लाइन. And we also studied the Cartesian plane. The Cartesian plane is basically a plane that is made up of the number lines that we have discussed. One is the horizontal and the another one is the vertical. So a Cartesian plane is a plane that is made up of the number lines, one horizontal and vertical, that is being intersected to each other at the origin at an angle of 90 degree. So that was the thing that we discussed already, right? Now in this chapter, in today's video, we are going to move further with the next topic, you can say that with the next topic, with the next concept of the Cartesian system, that is the Cartesian plane. And we are going to move further with the Cartesian plane. As you can see here friends, that on the board right now I have a Cartesian plane that has been divided into four parts, right? And these four parts here are already mentioned. So in the previous lecture we said that a Cartesian plane is made up of two number lines, that is one horizontal and other vertical, intersecting each other at origin at an angle of 90 degree, right? So that is a Cartesian plane. This is the Cartesian plane. Now friends, this Cartesian plane has four axes, you can say, or four lines starting with the origin. This is the origin here. As I can say that this O is the origin. Origin is a point from where the lines originates. Which lines? So that is X, Y, X dash and Y dash. So again you can write down a point here that four lines, which are the OX, OY, OX dash and OY dash, four lines OX, OY, OX dash and OY dash are the axis. See friends, this AXES is actually the plural form of axis. It is the plural form of axis, right? Four lines OX bar, OX, OY, OX dash and OY dash are the axis of the Cartesian plane. Right, these are the axis of the Cartesian plane. Now these axes also have a name. This axis, as we discussed, where you can write it like where. So I need to make a box over here so that I can write where OX is the where OX is the positive x-axis, right? OX is the positive x-axis, OY is the positive y-axis, then OX bar is the negative x-axis, and OY dash is the negative y-axis. Right, so these axes, these lines OX, OY, OX dash and OY dash having their names, which is this positive x-axis, positive y-axis, positive x-axis, sorry, negative x-axis and negative y-axis. Right, now friends, you can see here that whenever these two axes meet each other, that positive x and positive y-axis meet each other, they form a region somewhat like a square or a rectangular type, right? Because as the angle between them is 90, so you will form a square or a rectangle that is between the two axes. So the region that is being associated with the positive x-axis and positive y-axis is known as the first quadrant, or basically quadrant. Quadrant is a region, right? So whenever we talk about this axis, at that time you must come up with a term or with a word that is the quadrant, right? So let me again write down what is a quadrant. This was about the Cartesian plane that I have written here, and this was about the axis, right? Now I am going to write down here what the quadrant is, because after learning what the axes are, then we can study about the quadrant. So what is basically a quadrant? As the name suggests, quadrant, it means quad. Quad means four. You might have heard about a quad bike. Quad bike, that means a bike or a vehicle which has four tires or four wheels is known as a quad bike, right? So quadrant basically means four, and it means that whenever any plane is divided by the axis, then we get the plane divided into four parts, and which each of the part is known as a quadrant. So basically quadrant is a region on the Cartesian plane which is formed by the adjacent axis, or you can also say as coordinate axis. Friends, we need adjacent axis. Adjacent, that means near to each other, that means or close to each other. So if I am talking about this axis, then if it is positive x-axis, then the adjacent axis to this is either positive y or negative y. We cannot take negative x-axis because that covers two regions here, right? And a positive x-axis or positive y-axis or a negative y-axis comes in between. So we are going to take the regions which are covered by only and only the positive or negative, but they must be adjacent axis, right? Whether it is positive or whether it is negative, but they must be adjacent axis, or you can also call it as adjacent coordinate axis. As each of these axes covers some numbers, either positive or negative, they will be referred to as coordinates in the next part. So this is also known as the coordinate axis. So again friends, quadrant is a region that is covered by, sorry, is a region on the Cartesian plane that is formed by the adjacent axis or coordinate axis. This is known as a quadrant. Now the next point is in a plane, the axis or let me write down now the coordinate axis divides it. It, that means the plane. In a plane, the coordinate axis divides it into four regions or four quadrants, namely the names of each of these four are namely quadrant 1, quadrant 2, quadrant 3 and quadrant 4, right? So friends, you can see that the coordinate axis divides the plane into four regions or quadrants, which are they? Quadrant 1, quadrant 2, quadrant 3 and quadrant 4. So these four quadrants are the regions which the coordinate axis divides. So I have already written the plane here. Now friends, these are specific that which of the region will be called as quadrant 1, which of the region will be called as quadrant 2, which of the region will be called as 3 and the rest is 4. It is already fixed. You cannot take as whatever comes to your mind. So let me again say, describe that quadrant 1, quadrant 1 is the region between positive x axis and positive y axis. Okay, so quadrant 1 is the region between positive x axis and positive y axis. Similarly, quadrant 2, quadrant 2, that is between positive y axis, positive y axis, right? So this is positive y axis, but here now the x axis is negative and negative x axis, right? So this is known as quadrant 2. So quadrant 1, friends, again positive x and positive y, right? Quadrant 2, that means positive y and negative x. Similarly, quadrant 3, that will be negative x and negative y. So if I write here like quadrant 3 that will be between negative x axis and negative y axis, right? Negative x axis and negative y axis. So these are the regions here, the quadrants. First one is between positive x, positive y. Second one is between positive y, negative x. Third one is between negative x and negative y. And the fourth one is between negative y and positive x. So writing down the last one, quadrant 4, that is between negative y axis and positive x axis, right? So these are the quadrants, the regions. Again, quadrant 1, region between positive x and positive y. Quadrant 2, region between positive y and negative x. Quadrant 3, the region between negative x and negative y. and quadrant 4, last one, that is negative origin between negative y-axis and positive x-axis. So friends, I have already marked here, that is quadrant 1. This is quadrant 2. Quadrant 3 here. And last one, that is quadrant 4 here. Right? So this is how a Cartesian plane is divided into four regions, four quadrants by the coordinate axis. Now friends, whenever you will refer to the term coordinate axis, at that time you will come to the mind with the logic, with the system, that the coordinate axis are basically the number lines, one is horizontal and the second one is vertical, which are intersected to each other, or which intersects each other at the origin at an angle of 90 degree. That is what the basic description of the Cartesian plane is given. So these are the quadrants. Again, quadrant is a region on the Cartesian plane which is formed by the adjacent axis. Note that friends, this is important, whether the axis must be adjacent or any axis, right? By the adjacent axis or adjacent coordinate axis. And these are the four quadrants. Now, once we get ahead of this quadrants, now we are going to look for some points that are being given on the Cartesian plane. So friends, here as you can see that on the Cartesian plane I am having a point P and a point Q which are being in the first quadrant and the third quadrant respectively, right? I am having two points here, I am having two locations here, that is the first one P and the second one is Q. I am having the location here of these two points. The first one P lies in quadrant number 1 and the second one Q lies in quadrant number 3. Now you can see here that these points here, P and Q, are not actually located on the axis. On the axis, that means they are neither on positive x, on positive y, on negative x and negative. They are nowhere on the axis. Then what? They are actually in between the quadrants, in between these regions, or in between, you can say that in between the coordinate axis, right? So whenever you are in between something, or whenever a point is in between the axis, you will find yourself at some distance from a fixed point or the fixed line, right? Suppose that I am somewhere here near to Surendranagar in a field or on the road, and I have misguided, I have no internet connection so that I can go on to the Google Maps and see myself where I am. So what I am going to do is I am going to look for the kilometer marks on the road that we have, the milestone marks, right? We are going to look there. We know that it is 10 kilometers to Surendranagar and it is 20 kilometers to whatever the city you take, or 10 kilometers to Surendranagar and 50 kilometers to Chotila. Then I am somewhere located at a point. My address is that I am 10 kilometers away from Surendranagar and 50 kilometers away from Chotila. Right, so my thing, my address, my location is fixed. I will be somewhere over there. So in the same way, I am looking here, I am standing here at point P, and I know that I am at some distance from positive x axis and some distance from positive y axis. So how to find out this distance, friends? It is very simple to find out. There is no such thing you can have to do, or that is difficult for you to do. Now you just look for this distance P to N. How will you look for? You will directly see this on the positive x axis. The vertical distance will be measured on the vertical axis end, the horizontal distance will be measured on the horizontal axis. So first of all, the first thing you need to remember when locating a point, locating a point on the Cartesian plane. Right, locating a point on the Cartesian plane. The first thing that you need to remember here, that is, look or find the distance of the point. Find the distances of the point from the nearest coordinate axis, right? Find the distances of the point from the nearest coordinate axis. So nearest, the coordinate axis nearest to this point P here is positive x and positive y. So you will not go for looking that what is the distance of this point from this negative y axis or negative x axis. You will not look there, friends, right? Because that will not give you the proper answer. Now, how to find out the distance is, for vertical distance, look on the y-axis, and for horizontal distance, look on the x-axis. Right? So for vertical distance you will look on the y-axis, and for horizontal distance you will look on the x-axis. How? Y-axis and x-axis, or how the distance will be found out. First of all, let us find out the horizontal distance of this point, right? So for horizontal distance, how many length, or how much length this point P has covered when we project it on the horizontal axis? That is 4, right? So we can say that here this distance here of this P is 4, because there are 4 marks whenever we project. That means simply connecting that point with a straight line to the coordinate axis, that is known as projection. Projection simply means connecting the point with the straight line to the coordinate axis. So here this distance from M to P, that is 4, and this distance from N to P, that is 3, right? Yes or no? You will get this, because on the x-axis this point has covered 3 units, and on the y-axis this point has covered 3 units, and on the x-axis this has covered 4 units. So the distance here, distance MP, that is 4 units, and distance NP, that is 3 units. So we can say here that distance actually means the number of markings covered by the point on the coordinate axis. Here we are going to understand it like that, the distance of the point from the coordinate axis. So friends, here this point P has covered 4 units from the y-axis, and it has covered 3 units from the x-axis. So we can say that it is at a height of 3 units and it is 4 units inside, right? Now we just called this as the distance, but actually here in this topic we are going to look for the perpendicular distance. So finally the answer to this first point here, that is the perpendicular distance, the perpendicular distance of P the perpendicular distance of P from the x-axis, the perpendicular distance of the P from x-axis is 3 units, and that from the y-axis is 4 units. So that is the proper statement that you can write it down from this graph here, that the perpendicular distance of P, the perpendicular distance of P from x-axis, friends, where is x-axis? Here, this is the x-axis, right? So the perpendicular distance of this point from the x-axis, that means PN, this is the perpendicular distance, PN or NP is the perpendicular distance of the point P from the x-axis, and which is equals to 3 units. Similarly, the perpendicular distance of point P from the y-axis, that is MP, right, and which is equals to 4 units. Is this thing clear, everyone, friends? Right, so in the same way you can call it for the point Q also, right? Now friends, here we notice that whenever we had this point P, or whenever we talked about this point P, we had the positive numbers on both the axes, right? But now when we are dealing with the next point, that is point Q, which is located in the quadrant number 3, the coordinate axis to these, or this point here, will be both negative. Yes or no? Both are negative, because here it is x dash and here it is y dash. So both the coordinate axis, or both the axis that we have here, are negative. And friends, whenever we have this as negative, we come to the negative numbers. But don't worry about this, because distance is never negative. Did you find that you are going minus 10 kilometers to Ahmedabad? No, it is not possible. We always go 10 kilometers, 20 kilometers. That means we always travel the positive distance. So this point will also have traveled the positive distance. Now, as we can see here, that this point Q is how much distance away from the x-axis? I'm speaking x-axis, friends. Right? So the x-axis that will refer here to point Q is the negative x-axis. Is it clear? So how much distance this point Q is away from the negative x-axis? Where you will locate this? As I said, for vertical distance, you will look on the y-axis. So if I am finding out this vertical distance here, then where shall I look here? On the y-axis. See friends, this one is here. This is not the one. This is for the positive x-axis. So we shall look here for the y-axis, but this y-axis again here is the negative. So simply count out how many points this Q has covered, 1 and 2. So the distance here, that is QR, is 2, right? The distance here QR is 2, and similarly find out the distance QS, as this is a horizontal distance. And for horizontal distance, we will look on the x-axis. So this horizontal distance here will be 6 units, because this point Q is located 6 units away from the origin, or away from the point S. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Right? So that is how you get the distance of Q. So similarly for the second one, that is the perpendicular distance, the perpendicular distance of Q from, friends, let me write it down again. I need some space to write down the next point here. Okay, let me write it down here below. I am continuing this one here. The perpendicular distance of Q, the perpendicular distance of Q from the x-axis, from the x-axis is 2 units, and that from the y-axis is 6 units. So friends, as we have written that MP equals to 4 and NP equals to 3, here you can also write it down like QR is equals to 2 units and QS is equals to 6 units, right? QR equals to 2 units and QS is equals to 6 units. So this is how you can find out the distance, as we seen here that locating a point on the Cartesian plane. But here till now we didn't do anything, we just found out the distances of these points P and Q from their coordinate axis, from their nearest coordinate axis. Is it clear? Now friends, as I say that I want to locate a specific point, as I give you an example that I am somewhere here between Surendranagar and Chotila, I know that I am located at 10 kilometers away from Surendranagar and 50 kilometers away from Chotila, then what exact my position be? That is the thing, right? If I want to say to anybody, if I want to speak up to anybody, then what will I say? That where am I between these two, located at this distances? Because that is not possible, right? If I say that this is 3 units from x and 4 units from y, it is possible in 4 different ways. It would be either this also, it would be either this also, it would be either this also, but we don't know exactly that how it goes. So for that friends, whenever you are to locate a point on the coordinate x-axis, then we must have some coordinates. What we must have is the coordinates or the points, right? We must have the coordinates, as we seen in a recent movie, War. Have you seen War movie, right? In the last scene, when that missile is being taken off to destroy the Brahma missile, right? Or the Brahma satellite, at that time the coordinates, you will see or you will listen there that the characters are talking about the coordinates of the satellite. Coordinates of the satellite basically means the address of the satellite, and that satellite is right now not on the earth, it is in the outer space, right? So in the outer space we don't have any location, and that location, that specific location is being guided by those coordinates. So friends, these locations must be followed by the coordinates. So on earth also it is possible, right? Whenever if anyone asks you to share your location, then what you do? You go to Google Map, you will go for the live location and you will directly share it. But actually, you know what is the thing that goes behind that? That live location is actually your coordinates that is being with respect to the latitude and longitude, that you are located, you are standing here at 78 north latitude and 85 east latitude or 85 west latitude, whatever longitude, whatever your location be, right? So that is the perfect location, that is the coordinates of your location. In the same way, when we come to this Cartesian plane here, then we might come with a thing that we need the location of each and every points that is present in the Cartesian plane, right? So here, to find out the location of P, now the next point that is important, which I am writing here, that the location of point P is given by the point containing the coordinates or containing the x coordinate and y coordinate, right? The location of point P is given by, or the location of P is given by the point containing the x coordinate and y coordinate. Now, how this x coordinate and y coordinate is found out, or how this can be written, is x coordinate, right? I am having some little space here. So what I am going to do is erase this. Okay, let me erase the second point. I shall write it down again, friends. Don't worry. So the location of point P is given by the point containing the x coordinate, where x coordinate is the perpendicular, where the x coordinate is the perpendicular distance from the y axis, or x coordinate is the perpendicular distance from y axis, but along the x axis. Right? Understand the language, friends. What is this? X coordinate is the perpendicular distance from y axis. So this perpendicular distance from y axis, PM, but friends, it is said that along the x-axis, that means we are going to measure on the x-axis, but it is the perpendicular distance from y. So as I said, if I want to find out the distance PM, then what shall I do? I shall look for how many units the point M has covered on the x-axis. Number of points this point P has covered on the x-axis is the perpendicular distance from y-axis. That is same. It won't make any difference. And y-coordinate is the perpendicular distance from x-axis along y-axis, right? See, friends, this, the blue markings, the lines, the statements that I have written with the blue marks, that are for the understanding purpose. And I will strongly recommend you that you please note down these points, because these are actually not given in the textbook as I have written here, right? The language that is written in the textbook is somewhat in a difficult, the typical way. So please note this down, friends, so that you can easily understand the concept behind this, right? So that is how the point, the coordinates are being found out. So the location of point P is given by the point containing the x coordinate and the y coordinate, where x coordinate is the perpendicular distance from y axis along x axis, and y coordinate is the perpendicular distance from and y coordinate is the perpendicular distance from x axis along y axis. So here, therefore, coordinates of P are 4, 3. Can you write down? Right. See friends, x coordinate. What is x coordinate? X coordinate is the perpendicular distance from y axis. What is the perpendicular distance from y axis? 4. So that will be your x coordinate. Then here the y coordinate is the perpendicular distance from x axis. So what is that? 3. So that will be exactly 3. So this is how you can find out the location of any point, the coordinates of any point on the Cartesian plane, right? So here this was about the point P. Now let us discuss about point Q. So friends, here for finding out the coordinates of point Q, let me write it down here itself. For point Q, x coordinate is, what will be the x coordinate? As I said that x coordinate is the perpendicular distance from y axis. What is the perpendicular distance from y axis? 6. Yes or no? It is 6 and measured along the x axis. But friends, as we can see here that this x axis here is negative x axis. X axis here is negative x axis, and so the x coordinate is not 6 but it will be minus 6, and y coordinate is, now again, what is the perpendicular distance from x axis? That is 2, but when we measure this along the y axis, that becomes minus 1 and minus 2. So the y coordinate is minus 2. Therefore, coordinates of Q are -6, -2. Right, friends? So this is how you can find out the coordinates of any point located on the Cartesian plane. Is it clear, friends? So this is how it goes. Okay. Now, one more thing that I would like to add here. Whenever we are locating any point on a plane, then we must have their coordinates, right? But whenever we talk about the technical language, in mathematics, at that time, any point, I'm writing down a point here, point that means a note here, any point in the Cartesian plane has specific coordinates and is written in the manner of an ordered pair of x coordinate followed by the y coordinate in the brackets, right? In the brackets. So friends, see, as I have written here, this 4, 3. So the first one is the x coordinate and the second one is the y coordinate, followed by the the y coordinate followed by the x coordinate, and in the brackets here also, see, inside the brackets, the first one is the x coordinate and the second one is the y coordinate, right? And important note here that here the x coordinate of the point is known as, or is also called, abscissa. 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 And the y coordinate, and the y coordinate of the point is also called the ordinate, or is also called ordinate, or ordinate. You will simply remove the co from the word coordinate, and that will give you the word ordinate, right? So this is another names, important ones, that is being sometimes asked in the examination, that the x coordinate of the point is also called the abscissa, and the y coordinate of the point is also known as the ordinate, right? So that was about the Cartesian system, the Cartesian plane, the parts of the Cartesian plane, right? How to locate points on the Cartesian plane, what are the x coordinates, what are the y coordinates, perpendicular distance of any point from the coordinate axis, and so on. Now, in the next lecture, we shall find out some points located on the Cartesian plane, and we will also write down their abscissa and ordinates. Okay, friends?